preparing to spend the rest of my day poolside in order to avoid the Sunday scaries as much as possible after a week-long vacation I just had. But first, I'm going to go ahead and review the last dairy-free flavor that I have from the Jeni's dairy-free lineup. As a disclosure, there is, I think, one more dairy-free flavor that is, I think, like banana-based, but I have some sort of weird sort of allergic reaction to bananas in which they give me like terrible stomach cramps. So I kind of just try to steer away from those unless like absolutely necessary. So I will likely not be reviewing that one because I don't think it's worth the risk for me personally. But you know, feel free to check it out on your own and let me know, you know, what you think. But today I have dark chocolate truffle, dairy-free, of course. So the flavor story on this one, can you guess? So I says, forget everything that you knew, blah, 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 dairy-free. It's delicious, right? Okay. But then it goes, this flavor boasts an incredible amount of rich and complex fair trade cocoa for palate gripping taste and a bit of coconut cream for perfectly scoopable body and extra layer of depth. It's a true chocolate maker's frozen treat. Palate gripping is also a like favorite by the Jeni's marketing team whenever they're describing anything that's chocolate. The little flavor description up here says, complex and ethereal flavor from the best cocoa the world has to offer. Finishes with an ultralight hint of coconut cream. There we go, there's the carton. I don't think I've shown a carton in a while. Nothing too crazy, just like a little chocolate splotch. I have had this sitting out for like somewhere between 5 and 10 minutes because when I took it out of my freezer, it is like rock hard, like more so than any other flavor that I've had straight out the freezer. So it needed some time to kind of soften up to be able to do this. And it's still pretty firm. Not really expecting much from this one. It's a plain flavor, no mix-ins, nothing like that. You know, it's just chocolate. That's it. Here we go. See a nice chocolate swirl. This sort of reminds me of like the little cups of ice cream you would get as a kid in like the lunchroom. Looks like that. So let's get into it. We go with a nice scoop. It has been sitting out long enough. To be scoopable. Looks like it's got some good texture there. Let's go in. It does sort of taste like exactly like the chocolate you would get in those little like chocolate vanilla swirl cups. Just richer, a little more decadent. On the very back end of it, there's like the slightest hint of coconut flavor. But I don't know that I would pick up on it if I didn't know it was in there. So something to keep in mind for my dairy-free folks who are not fans of coconut, I don't think this one's noticeable. Yeah. It's a totally decent chocolate. Again, you guys know how I feel about plain flavors. You guys know that I prefer mix-ins, swirls, crunchies, like whatever. So this obviously isn't going to rank as high as some of my other flavors, but that's just my own personal bias. If you are a plain Jane, plain John sort of person who, you know, digs just plain flavors, I think you're really gonna like this, especially if you're looking for a dairy-free option. It's really yummy. I also think you can do a lot to like dress this up. Probably defeats the purpose a little bit, but you know, you could put fruit in it, you could put peanut butter, you could put nuts, you could, you know, chocolate, caramel, whatever. It's gonna be a great base for like a sundae. It'd be great in a cone. The beauty about plain flavors is that you can do whatever the fuck you want with them to zhuzh them up, you know? So that is an option here. But given all of that, for a rating, I think I might give this like a 5, you know? It's very yummy, but very unsurprising, you know? There's not much going on. It just is what it is. 5 out of 10 for Jeni's dark chocolate truffle, dairy-free. That is the last one I have of the dairy-free flavors. However, the summer lineup has dropped recently. So Jeni came out with, I think, five flavors for the summer. Three of them are completely brand new. The other two I have already tried. So I can link the videos to Golden Nectar, which is out now, below. And I don't remember what the other flavor is off the top of my head that I already had. I want to say Wildberry Lavender. I can also link that one down below as well. I will be ordering the other three flavors that I've never tried before on the 21st of this month. So I should have them in the following week and can review those three new ones for you. But in the meantime, go check out the videos that I already did for the reviews for the flavors that are out now. And that's the scoop. I'll see you next time.